Prince Charles is reported to want to cut the number of working members of the monarchy when he becomes king. Which royals are most likely to be axed from the firm in future? Prince Charles, 72, is understood to want to reduce the cost of the royal family to the British taxpayer by slimming down the firm and having fewer working royals when he is king. While senior members of the monarchy, including Charles's son Prince William, 39, his wife Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, and rising stars Sophie, Countess of Wessex, 56, and Prince Edward, 57, are likely to stay on as working royals, there are a plethora of lesser-known members of the firm who could get the chop. Giles Brandreth, author of Philip, The Final Portrait, previously told the Daily Express he thinks, going forward we are going to go back to a much slimmed-down monarchy. He said the late Duke of Edinburgh was also supportive of the move, which would see members outside of the immediate family taking a more background position. Mr. Brandreth claimed Philip told him that when he became the Duke of Edinburgh in 1947, the royal family only comprised of the King and the Queen and the two young princesses. He said, that was it really. That was the royal family. And now of course it became this larger thing altogether. Royal biographer Angela Levin has claimed Charles has wanted to trim down the monarchy for a very long time. She told Talk Radio he wanted to do so in order to save costs and make people be worth the money that they get from the taxpayer. Which royals could be cut from the firm when Charles is king? There are a number of lesser-known working royals, mostly cousins of the Queen, who could lose their positions in the monarchy when Charles is king. While many of them are close to retirement age, if they are still working to support the crown when Charles takes the throne, they may face being axed. Express.co.uk has rounded up the most likely working royals to be cut from a slimmed-down monarchy. The Duke of Kent. Prince Edward, the Duke of Kent, 85, is the Queen's first cousin. His father, Prince George, was the Queen's uncle. The Duke of Kent is also Edward's first cousin once removed, as well as a second cousin of Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh via his mother, Princess Marina of Greece and Denmark. Prince Edward is 39th in line to the throne but still carries out royal duties on behalf of the crown, including more than 60 overseas tours. A description of the Duke of Kent's work on the royal family's website reads, as vice chairman of the Overseas Trade Board, and later of British Trade International, 1976-2001, the Duke of Kent has undertaken over 60 overseas trips to promote British trade and exports, including to Europe, Japan, Australia and the Middle East. He was also the first member of the royal family to make an official visit to China. The Duke of Kent is involved with over 140 different charities, organizations and professional bodies which cover a wide range of issues, from commemorating the war dead to fostering the development of British technology and industry. His Royal Highness undertakes numerous engagements each year in support of these organizations, both in the UK and across the Commonwealth. Princess Alexandra. Princess Alexandra, 84, also known as the Honourable Lady Ogilvy, is the Queen's cousin. She is royal patron or president of more than 100 organisations which reflect her wide-ranging interests, from the arts to healthcare. She also supports the Queen in her duties as head of state, attending ceremonial occasions alongside other members of the firm. Princess Alexandra was born to Prince George, Duke of Kent, and Princess Marina of Greece and Denmark. Her mother was a first cousin of the Queen's husband, Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh. She was also his first cousin once removed. A description of her royal work on the firm's official website reads, Princess Alexandra is the Queen's cousin and a working member of the royal family. She is patron or president of over 100 organizations which reflect her wide-ranging interests, from the arts to healthcare. She also supports the Queen in her duties as head of state, attending ceremonial occasions alongside other members of the royal family. The Duke and Duchess of Gloucester. Prince Richard, Duke of Gloucester, 76, is a paternal first cousin of Queen Elizabeth II. He is the second son of Prince Henry, Duke of Gloucester and Princess Alice, Duchess of Gloucester, and the youngest of the 9 grandchildren of King George V and Queen Mary. He was 5th in the line to the British throne at birth but has since moved down to 30th. His wife Birgitta van der Zee, 75, became the Duchess of Gloucester upon their marriage in July 1972 and they have 3 children together. A description of the Duke of Gloucester and his full-time working role on the royal family's website reads, "The Duke of Gloucester is the Queen's cousin and a full-time working member of the royal family. He attends national and international events in support of the Queen and her duties as head of state, as well as undertaking extensive public duties and engagements every year reflecting his own interests and charities." Prince and Princess Michael of Kent. Prince Michael of Kent, 79, is a paternal first cousin of the Queen, being a grandson of King George V and Queen Mary. He is 51st in the line of succession, but at the time of his birth was 7th in the line. He is married to Princess Michael of Kent, born Baroness Marie Christine Anna Agnes Hedwig Ida von Riebnitz, 76, and together they carry out duties on behalf of the crown. A description of the couple's work on the royal family's official website reads, Prince Michael is involved in around 100 charities and organizations, including being patron for a large number of these. Each year, he undertakes on average over 200 public working engagements for the not-for-profit sector, funded by his own household. The charities vary from reflecting his interest in transport, for example being patron of the Brooklands Museum Trust, to his passion for Russia, including his own charity, the Prince Michael of Kent Foundation, which works to benefit heritage, culture, health and postgraduate business education in Russia. Prince Michael has also taken part in fundraising challenges such as when he led a rally of Bentleys from Brooklands Museum in the UK to Moscow, covering 1,700 miles in 10 days and raising more than £25,000 for the Children's Fire and Burns Trust. Princess Michael is also actively involved in around 45 different charities and organizations, including animal and wildlife trusts and health and welfare charities. Reflecting her interest in the arts, she is also involved in the work of many cultural institutions in various countries, including being patron of the London Arts Orchestra and of the Budapest Festival Orchestra. If you liked this video, please hit the like button to give this channel a boost. If you would like to see more royal family news, please hit the subscribe button and hit the little bell to be notified of the future videos.